Goodwill Community Foundation, creating opportunities for a better life.
Filtering is a great feature of Excel that gives you a lot of control over which parts of your worksheet are displayed. You can use it to show only the information you need or find something specific while hiding the rest of the data temporarily. Now, it's important that you have a header row because the filtering tools actually get added to the cells in the header row. In this example, I have an equipment checkout log, and there are a lot of things to keep track of, so I'd like to use some of the filters to simplify it. First, go to the Data tab and click the Filter command. And you'll see these drop-down arrows added to your header row. These are what you'll use to access all of the filtering options. Here you'll see a list of all of the different values that appear in this column. I'd like to just view the laptops and projectors, so I'll uncheck this box to quickly deselect everything, then check Laptop and Projector. Click OK. And now the drop-down arrow has changed to a different icon to show that there is a filter in this column. We can narrow down this data even further by adding another filter to a different column. Let's filter by the date that the items were checked out. This shows all of the months that appear in this column, so I'll uncheck the months that I don't want, then click OK. To get rid of any filter, just click the icon again, and select Clear Filter. So that's how you do simple filtering. And now let's look at some more advanced techniques. Using the same menu, we can also search for values that appear in this column. In this example, a lot of our equipment is made by a company called Ceres. So if we enter that here, Excel will look for a match anywhere in these cells, and then list only those results below. To apply the filter, just click OK. For a little more control, you can use text filters instead. You can access these from the same menu under Text Filters. Here you can filter information that fits more specific criteria, for example, cells that contain a certain number of characters, or data that doesn't contain a word that you specify. In this example, we're going to choose Does Not Contain, and then enter Laptop to exclude anything that contains this word, including laptops and laptop travel bags. Click OK, and Excel will refilter the data. Next, let's say I only want to show items where the ID number is between 3,000 and 6,000. I can click the drop-down arrow and go to Number Filters. There are a lot of different options here, but for what I need, I'm going to choose Between. Now I can type in whatever values I want in these two fields. So this will show rows that are greater than or equal to 3,000 and less than or equal to 6,000. Click OK. And now all of these values are between 3,000 and 6,000. Date filters are really cool because they can display data from a certain time period, such as last year, next quarter, between two dates, and more. In this example, I'd like to find out which items were checked out this week. All you have to do is go to Date Filters, and you'll find many options to choose from. I'll select This Week. At this point, we have three different filters applied to the worksheet. So it's filtering out most of the items and just showing the ones that meet all of the criteria. If you'd like to remove any of the filters, you can clear them one by one like I showed you before, or you can turn off filtering altogether. Just click the Filter command again. As you can see, filtering can narrow things down really quickly, and it gives you so many different options, you can probably find a use for it with any worksheet.